Myself, Mr. Sunil Datta N. Kulkarni, Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to deliver a video session on steady state heat conduction. At the end of this session, you will be able to calculate the temperature distribution and heat flow rate through composite structures. The contents of this video session are heat transfer through composite structures and concept of overall heat transfer coefficient. As we are aware that most of the practical applications involve composite structures or composite wall. The composite structure means the structure which is made up of the materials having various conductivity. For example, if we see the walls of refrigerator, walls of cold storage, walls of furnace, these are made up of various material. In this case, to find out the heat transfer through such composite structure, we require to use electrical analogy method. If the first problem we will take of heat transfer through composite wall. For the purpose, let us consider one composite wall which is made up of two different materials having thermal conductivity K1 and K2 and having the thickness in the direction of heat flow. For material 1, the thickness is B1 and for material 2, the thickness is B2. The temperatures on the outer side and inner surface of the wall are T1 and T3 and interface temperature between the two materials is T2. Let us assume that this particular wall is also having a convective environment. On inner side of this particular wue, we are assuming that the hot flue gases are there and heat transfer coefficient is HI. Whereas on outer side, the ambient air is present with heat transfer coefficient of HO. Now to write down the heat flow rate equation for this composite wall, we can develop the electrical circuit, which is, now if we consider this problem, in this problem we are having two conductive resistance because we are having two material, and on left hand side there will be a convective resistance. By using electrical analogy method, we know that Q is equal to HA delta T. If we rearrange that, Q will be equal to 1 upon delta T upon 1 upon HA. So convective resistance is given by 1 upon H into A. Therefore, I can write the first resistance which is there between the temperatures of TG and T1 as 1 upon HA into A. The conductive resistance for first material, I can write it as B1 upon K1A. For second material, I can write the conductive resistance as B2 upon K2A. And on outer side, the heat transfer from the furnace outer surface to the surrounding air will be happening by convection, for which the temperature of surrounding air is TA and heat transfer coefficient is HO. So I can write here the convective resistance as 1 upon HO into A. Since in case of plain wall, the area of heat flow, if we see here, it will be constant in the normal to the direction of heat flow. So here the area of heat flow we can assume to be throughout uniform, which is A. So I can write the equation for heat flow rate as Q is equal to, now I will take the temperature difference at the two ends, that is temperature of hot gases minus temperature of ambient air, divided by summation of all these resistances, that is 1 upon HR into A plus B1 upon K1A plus B2 upon K2A plus 1 upon HO into A. Since area of heat flow is constant, we can take it common from the denominator and I can take it as 1 upon HA to the left hand side, and by rearranging the equation, I can write this equation as Q is equal to TG minus TA into A divided by 1 upon HI plus B1 upon K1 plus B2 upon K2 plus 1 upon HO. So by using this electrical analogy method, we have converted the steady state heat conduction through composite wall into electric circuit, and using the electrical analogy method, we have obtained very easily the equation for heat flow rate. This way, we can use the electrical analogy to solve any number of layers if they are present. We have to take into account that how many materials are there. Accordingly, we have to add the thermal conductive thermal resistances in the circuit. If they are arranged in series, we have to take the resistance in series. If they are arranged in parallel, we have to take the, using the law of electrical energy, parallel resistances we can find as one upon R equivalent is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So we have to take equivalent resistance if they are parallel. For series, we can directly as R equivalent will be equal to R1 plus R2. Now let us see the concept of overall heat transfer coefficient. Now usually, the heat transfer by combined modes of conduction and convection are defined by using the term overall heat transfer coefficient. And equation, the heat flow rate is expressed in terms of overall heat transfer coefficient as Q is equal to UA into delta T. Now, if we give the equation number 1 to this, and already we have just now derived the equation for heat flow rate through composite wall as Q is equal to TG minus TA into A divided by summation of various resistances like 1 upon HI plus B1 by K1 plus B2 by K2 plus 1 upon HO. So if we compare the equations 1 and 2 by making the comparison on the right hand side, we will get that 1 upon UA into A will be equal to 1 upon summation of all resistances. So we can write it as U into A is equal to, if we cancel the A, we can write directly U is equal to 1 upon summation R. Therefore, we will be getting U is equal to 1 upon HI plus B1 by K1 plus B2 by K2 plus 1 upon HO. So for a for wall or cylinder or sphere, we can use the concept of overall heat transfer coefficient to find out the heat flow rate when it is occurring by combined modes of conduction and convection. Now let us see how to find out the heat flow rate through composite cylinder which is made up of two materials. Again, we are assuming that these cylinders are coaxial and length of cylinder is L and it is also exposed to the convective environment. For that purpose, I have assumed that the inner radius cylinder, radius of inner cylinder is R1 and outer radius is R2, whereas inner radius of outer cylinder is R2 and outer radius of outer cylinder layer is R3. And assuming that the materials are having thermal conductivity K1 and K2, let the hot gas or hot steam is flowing through inside this particular hollow cylinder for which the heat transfer coefficient is HI. And on the outside, we are having the ambient at temperature TA and heat transfer coefficient as TO. Now, again, by using a electrical analogy method, we can write the electrical circuit for this composite cylinder problem as it is having again two conductive resistances for two materials having conductivities K1 and K2 and two convective resistance, one on inner surface and other on outer surface. So we can write the convective resistance as, first convective resistance as 1 upon HI into AI, conductive resistance for first layer of the material ln of R2 by R1 upon 2 pi K1L, ln of R3 by R2 upon 2 pi K2L, and 1 upon HO into AO. The major difference between plane wall and cylinder is that in case of cylinder, the area of heat flow does not remain constant. So we can write as the area AI for inner cylinder will be equal to 2 pi R1L, whereas the outer surface area of the cylinder through which the heat will be lost by convection will be given by 2 pi R3 into L. So by putting this equation, these AI and AO values in the above resistances, I can write the equation for heat flow rate as Q is equal to TG minus TA divided by summation R, summation of all thermal resistances, which I can further write it as Q is equal to TG minus TA divided by 1 upon HI into inner surface area of the inner sphere, that is 2 pi R1L plus the conductive resistance for Plain cylinder, we know that ln of R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi K1 L. Similarly, I can write the conductive resistance for second sphere as ln of R3 by R2 divided by 2 pi K2 L plus convective resistance on the outer surface, that is 1 upon HO into 2 pi R3 L. If we take 2 pi L as the common term from the denominator, we can write this equation as Q is equal to 2 pi L Tg minus Ta divided by 1 upon Hi into R1 plus ln of R2 by R1 divided by K1 plus ln of R3 by R2 divided by K2 plus 1 upon HO into R3. So this equation gives us the heat flow rate for composite cylinder, which is transferred by P.K. Nag, Tata McGraw-Hill Publishing Company Limited, New Delhi, and heat and mass transfer by R.K. Rajput, S. Chand and Company Limited, New Delhi. Thank you.